Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue our first unit. So let's see about the concept of EMI or EMC and some definitions. Okay, so first we are going to see about the electromagnetic disturbance. What is electromagnetic disturbance? It is just a phenomena which will degrade the performance of a device. Okay, which will reduce the performance of a device, that is due to the noise, natural electromagnetic noise or some unwanted signal or change in the propagation medium itself. We know there are various propagation medium, so if there is any change in the propagation medium, or if there is any noise, natural noise, or if there is any unwanted signals, it will cause some disturbance, that is called electromagnetic disturbance. This will degrade the performance of the device. Okay, next one is electromagnetic interference. What is electromagnetic interference? It is just the degradation in the performance of a device or equipment, okay, or a system, caused by this disturbance. So due to this electromagnetic disturbance, something, it will affect the performance of a device. Okay, so that is called the electromagnetic interference. Then radio frequency interference, that is just nothing but it is the degradation in the reception of the unwanted signal due to the frequency disturbance. Okay, if there is some frequency determines, if the disturbance is caused by some radio frequency, then we can say it is a radio frequency interference. Then what is electromagnetic compatibility? What is electromagnetic compatibility? An electronic system that is able to function even if there is some interference or disturbance also. If the system can work properly in the electronic in that environment, we can say that is a electromagnetic compatible. It is electromagnetic compatible with this environment. Okay, that is even if there is some disturbance, if it is able to function properly or somewhat clearly, we can say it is a electromagnetic compatible. Okay, then examples of EMI. okay, so now just we are going to see the examples from where we get the electromagnetic interference. Okay, first one is transmission lines. From the transmission lines, we know high intensity electric or magnetic field near the transmission lines cause unintentional activation or explosion of the electrode explosive device apart from presenting radiation hazards to humans. Okay, from the transmission lines also we can say there will be a lot of interference which will affect the electronic device, or it will also cause the hazards to human, radiation hazards to humans. Okay, so if there is a high intensity electric or magnetic field near the transmission lines, it will cause some unintentional activation or explosion. Okay, explosion of the device, and also it will cause the radiation hazards to humans. Okay, next one is the mains power supply. Okay, is so here we can say if there is thunderstorm or lightning, we know there will be some sudden spark in the supply line of our homes and all, right? That is the main power supply line. That is, it easily pick up the electromagnetic noise from the lightning and thunderstorm. Okay, transient from circuit breakers, switches, etc., and impair the operation of computer and main IT products. Extensive precautions and therefore necessarily invariably taken in designing and installing for computer installation. Okay, so just we know in many of the situation during the thunderstorm, we will switch off our TV, fridge, all the electronic items, we will off it, right? So that is, otherwise it will damage our equipment. That is the example of the electromagnetic interference of through mains power supply. Then switches and relays. So the electrical discharge from this switches and relays also there will be some electrical discharge. Okay, so it will also affect the telephone circuits and radio telescope. So the electronic discharge from the switches and relays will also cause the electromagnetic interference. Okay, the next one, telephone equipments. Okay, if the field strength near the telephone equipment is greater than 1 volt per meter, they pick up the transmission from the nearby television station. Okay, we know. When we place a mobile near a television or something like that, we know there is a vibration sound. That okay, that is the, what is that? That is the interference caused by that radiation. Okay, field, that electric or magnetic field. Okay, so that in the this intensity of the EMI depends on what operating frequency, output power level, EMI, and the limiting measures used in the design, installation, and operation of the equipment. So, how hard the interference, that will depends on the operating frequency, output power level, EMI limiting measures used in the design, installation, and operation of this equipment, etc. Okay. Then the aircraft navigation. Okay, use of TV set or laptop and the mobile devices in the aircraft navigation affects the navigational equipment during takeoff and landing. Okay, this aircraft navigation. Okay, when we use this TV set, laptop, mobile devices, also when we are traveling, when we are using aircraft navigation, it will also cause the interference. Okay. Then biological effects. Okay, exposure of humans to the high intensity electromagnetic field induces steady current. If exploded long time, surging of shock current through the body when a person located in the high intensity field touches a motor vehicle in this place. We can ask biological effects. We know the thunderstorm and lightning will affect us, right? So similar to that, high radiation will affect the human health. Okay, it will make some health hazards to the human. That is the biological effects. So then military equipment. So if there is an interference in the, if there is any interference in the missile or rocket launch vehicle, it will cause the launch failure. It will affect the we cannot able to launch that vehicle or missile properly if there is any electromagnetic interference. Okay, then insecure communication means unintentional electromagnetic emission through the radiation and or conduction of an intelligence bearing signal can be analyzed by sensor, which leads to the insecure communication. Communication, that is when we are using telephone, we know there will be some unwanted signals coming through the phone, right? While communication is taking place, that is the insecure communication. That is all happens because of the unintentional electromagnetic emission. Then a system with tempest protection. Tempest is used to denote a whole set of highly sensitive specification and special measurement procedure for ensuring compliance with these specifications. So tempest, it is just used to denote the highly sensitive specification and special measurement procedure to ensure the compliance with this specification. Okay, just difficulty in that just read it. Integrated circuits. Okay, integrated EMIC, electromagnetic interference in integrated circuits sometimes burn out the device.
So if the radiation is if the interference, electromagnetic interference, if there is interference in the integrated chip, sometimes it will cause the device to burn out. Okay, so in digital circuit, EMI increases bit error rate or malfunctioning of the circuit. So when we are working a digital circuit, and if there is some interference or something like that, it will affect the circuit performance. Okay, so in analog circuit, it will increase the noise level and degrade the operation of the circuit and the system. Then radio astronomy. Okay, weak radio signal from pulsars and distant galaxies are difficult to detect due to EMI from terrestrial sources like digital clock pulses, power supplies, noise bands from the operation of relays, switches, etc. So we know the radio, so we know the research are going on the various space topics, right? So if there is some interference from terrestrial sources like digital clock pulse, power supply, noise burst, or from the operation of relays or switch, which will affect the detection of the radio signal from pulsars or distant galaxies. This one we just discussed in the last class, that is the basic types of EMI. What are the two types of EMI? Intra EMI and inter EMI. Okay, that is, it is to be EMI is said to be intra EMI if the functional characteristics of one module within an electronic equipment or system is disturbed due to the EMI from another module. Okay, that is between the two modules inside a single system. What is inter EMI? If the functional characteristics of one equipment is disturbed due to the EMI generated by the equipment. So one is disturbed due to another equipment, we can say is inter EMI. We know during the engineering, in the engineering practices laboratory, when they are doing some welding the electronics, welding, it will cause some interference to the electric devices that is using the nearby. Okay, so that is the inter EMI. Next, basic elements are of EMI. What are the basic elements of EMI? So the basic elements of EMI are source or emitter or culprit, then coupling path or medium, then receiver or receptor or victim. Source and victim will be there, and in between that there will be a coupling path or connecting path or a medium will be there. Okay, so if we take, that is transmitter will be there, or that is emitter will be there, then the medium will be there, it may be air or something like that, then victim or receptor or the receiver will be there. So the source, that is the emitter, will produce the emission. Okay, and a transfer or coupling path transforms this emission energy to the receptor, where it is processed, resulting in either desired or undesired behavior. It just depends on the coupling path of or the medium. Okay, so these are the basic elements of EMI, electromagnetic interference. Source, emitter or culprit will be there, then there is a coupling path or medium is there, then receiver or receptor or victim is there. So this is the mechanism of the electromagnetic interference that we discussed in the last class. So source will be there, the receptor will be there, there will be various path. Okay, so the number 4 shows the power lines. Okay, and that is the emission from the source is picked up by the power lines, and then it will pass on to the receptor. And in the first one, number 1 shows the direct source to receptor, then from source to some objects picked up the emission from the source and give it to the receptor. In the third, also from the source, it will be absorbed by some obstacles, then transfer it to the receptor. They are the same. Okay. So the first path is the direct radiation from source to receptor, then direct radiation from the source picked up by the power, by the electrical power cables or the signal or control cables connected to the receptor, which reaches the receptor via the conduction path. Then electromagnetic interference radiated by the electrical power signal or control cable of the source. Electromagnetic interference directly conducted from a source to the receptor with through a common electrical power supply line or through a common signal or control cables. So there are two mechanisms by which the electromagnetic interference. So from source to receptor there is a coupling path, right? So there are two mechanisms, okay, by which these signals are moving from source to receptor. Okay, that are called radiation and conduction. Okay, that are the two mechanisms. So next one is the source of EMI. Okay, source, what are the sources of electromagnetic interference? Okay, so there are two types of source, natural as well as human made source. What are the natural source of EMI? Stars, sun, natural phenomena such as atmospheres, lightning, thunderstorm, electrostatic discharge. On the other hand, electromagnetic, it is also generated due to some various electrical, electronic and electromechanical apparatus. Okay, so this the interference generated by this various equipments and appliances is human made. Okay, so there, what are the sources of EMI? There are two sources of EMI, that is natural and human made. What are the natural sources of EMI? Atmospheric lightning, thunderstorm, electrostatic discharge. Then what are the human made source of electromagnetic interference? That is electrical, electronic and from the electromechanical apparatus. So the figure shows the various source of electromagnetic interference. So the electromagnetic interference, it is of two types, equipment noise and natural noise. Okay, the equipment noise is again divided into the noise from the system or circuit and components. From the noise from the system includes communication, radar or navigation equipments, fluorescent tube light, automobile ignition, industrial equipment such as arc welders, heaters, etc., electric traction, appliances such as microwave, oven, mixer, vacuum cleaners, electric shavers, etc. Circuits and components include local oscillator, switches, motors, filters, relays, non-linear circuit elements, circuit breakers, magnetic armatures, latching contactors, logic and digital circuits, arcing due to improper contacts, corona, rusty contacts. Okay, so these are the equipment noise. Then the natural noise, it is of two types, terrestrial and celestial noise. So the terrestrial noise include atmospheric noise, lightning, then electrostatic discharge. Okay, then celestial noise include cosmic or galactic noise, solar noise. So this is an important question. Okay, source and victims of EMI. So let's see in details. Celestial electromagnetic noise. So we know what are the celestial bodies, suns, stars, galaxies, etc. Okay, we know these have very high temperature, right? So the air radiation from these will attribute to the random motion of charged ions resulting from thermal ionization at very high temperature. Okay. So we know these are of high temperature, so the radiation from that is high, right? So it will attribute to the random motion of the charged ions, which result in the thermal ionization at very high temperature. Okay. So these heated parts of this celestial bodies emits the thermal noise. So it will just produce the thermal noise, which is the electromagnetic interference, which is the main source of the electromagnetic interference. Okay, the characteristics of such emission depends on the temperature obtained by these bodies. Okay, so it will just this thermal noise is just mainly depends on what it just mainly depends on the temperature of the this thing. Okay, sun, stars, galaxies, etc. So the main potential source of this discrete emissions are Sun, Moon, Jupiter. Okay, so this is the potential source of the discrete emission from the celestial body. Okay, so this will emit the broadband as well as narrow band electromagnetic noise. Okay, this will emit broadband as well as narrow band electromagnetic noise. So the radiation from the sun changes drastically during solar flares and sunspot activity. So this will just you have to read it. Okay, so the next one, this is just a spectral distribution of this celestial electromagnetic noise. Okay, how the power flux density as well as the frequency graph. So it will just shows the spectral distribution of the celestial electromagnetic noise. Okay, just go through it. Next one and the important one is the lightning discharge. Okay, it's an important question. So the atmospheric electromagnetic noise is caused by the electric discharge in the atmosphere, right? So this can be either a localized or a area field or an area phenomena. So the main strong source of the atmospheric noise are lightning and electrostatic discharge. This is the important thing. Lightning and electrostatic discharge are the strong sources of the atmospheric noise. Okay, so how the lightning occur? We all know lightning and thunderstorm, right? So how the lightning occur? Why the lightning is happening? So it just occur as a result of electric discharge in the atmosphere from a charge bearing cloud. Okay, so it is just the discharge of electric, okay, electric discharge, okay, discharge of the electrons. Okay, lightning occurs as a result of the discharge of the electrons in the atmosphere. So we know clouds, right? These clouds have some charges, right? So the clouds, how the clouds gets charged? This will capture charge from the atmosphere. As a result of the charge accumulation, clouds acquire sufficiently high potential with respect to the ground. So we know clouds, right? Between the clouds, if the clouds what to say, because of this clouds lightning is happening, right? In this clouds it have some charge, right? So how the charge is occurred in this clouds? It is from the atmosphere. It captures the charge from the atmosphere. As a cumulative result of the charge accumulation, the clouds acquire sufficiently high potential with respect to the ground. So comparing to the ground, it have the high potential. Okay, there will be some breakdown level. Okay, breakdown level for the clouds to keep the charge. So when the intensity in a charged cloud exceeds this breakdown level, the result will be an electric discharge. Okay, if the intensity of the electric field intensity or the field intensity in a charged cloud, intensity in the cloud exceeds some breakdown level, the result will be an electric discharge. Okay, so there are two types of discharges. Discharges taken place from cloud to ground as well as from one cloud to another cloud. Okay, so what are the two types of lightning discharge? From cloud to cloud and cloud to ground discharge. Okay, so what is cloud to ground discharge? So we know if the field intensity goes if the field intensity in the clouds exceeds the breakdown level, the electric discharge, that is, what is electric discharge? That is the flow of the electrons, right? So the flow of the electrons will takes place, right? So what is cloud to ground discharge? So the charge in charge carriers, that is the electrons in this clouds, will start to flow from the cloud when it exceeds the breakdown level to the ground. Okay, from the cloud to ground, that is the cloud to ground discharge. Okay, that is the lightning. Okay, we know many people are died because of the lightning, that many trees are burned because of the lightning, many electrical equipments are burned because of the lightning, right? So these all happens because of the cloud to ground discharge. That is the electrons from the clouds or the field in, if the field intensity of the clouds exceeds the breakdown level, it will start to flow from the cloud. So if it flows from the one cloud to ground, we can say it is a cloud to ground discharge. Okay, it will cause serious health issues to the humans, right? You know, right? So the total discharge between a cloud and the ground, it is called a flash. Okay, it just lasts about 0.5 seconds. Okay, it just consists of a series of high current pulse. We know it's the flow of electrons, right? So we know it consists of a series of high current pulse, okay, which is called stroke. This current pulse is called stroke, and this strokes will last about 1 millisecond. Okay, it will last about 1 millisecond, and the separation time between strokes is about 40 to 80 milliseconds. In between that, the second strokes will came. So as we know, the electrons from the clouds will channeled towards the ground in a series of short luminance steps. That is called step ladder. If you go on to the certain videos in the YouTube, you will get clear idea about the cloud to ground discharge. Okay, the a preliminary breakdown in the cloud set the stage for negative charge or electrons to be channeled towards the ground in a series of short luminance step. It is called step ladder. Just please go through this small definitions. Okay, the ladder steps are typically of 1 microsecond duration and tens of meter in length, with a pause time between the step of about 50 microsecond. Okay, then remaining just you have to read it. So when the charge exceeds the breakdown level, it starts to flow from the cloud. That is called cloud to ground discharge. Okay. So this in the cloud to ground discharge, when the flow of the electrons is taking place from cloud to ground, the tallest thing, whatever it is, when it is flowing, it will capture this electrons, okay, this electrons, and it will flow to the ground. That is the thing happen. The trees will burn, right? Also it will affect the humans, right? So that's the thing happened. Then cloud to ground, cloud to cloud discharge. What is cloud to cloud discharge? That is just refers to the all discharges that do not contact the ground. That is we know clouds, right? So if the one cloud which occur what a lot of electrons and it exceeds the breakdown level, it starts to flow, right? So if the electrons from one cloud flows to the another cloud, we can say it is cloud to cloud discharge, which it will not reach the ground. Okay, so the static charges acquired by this cloud produces a static electric field. The value of this electric field intensity can be estimated from a knowledge of the charge distribution and the distance from the ground. So what about the duration of this electrical and magnetic field transient caused by the lightning process? It will be of the order of the fraction of microsecond. Okay, within some microseconds these all thing will happen. So the current that produce these fields are also have a similar duration. Next is electrostatic discharge, ESD, phenomena and effect. Okay, so the electric state discharge, it is a natural phenomena in which accumulated static electric charges are discharged. It is just the discharge of the static electric charges. Okay, this discharge will produce the electromagnetic interference. Okay, so how the static electricity is generated, how it is generated? So when the two material of different dielectric constant will rub against each other, we can say there will be some static electricity. Okay, that is the generation of the static electricity. Okay, when two different, it is generated when two material of the different dielectric constant rub against each other. Example, wool and glass, etc. Okay, no. Charging of the material body may also result from heating or through contact with the charged body. Okay, we know if we rub the scale in some cloth and if we place some piece of paper, cut some piece of paper, and if we place the scale nearby, it will capture the paper will attach to the scale. That is because of this static electricity. Okay, charging of the material body may also result from heating or through contact with a charged body. Okay, the static charge is discharged to the another object which has a low resistance to the ground. The effect of such a discharge will result in the electromagnetic interference could vary from noise and disturbance in audio or measuring instruments to unpleasant electric shock to the equipment or person involved. Okay, so the main this discharge will sometimes cause the electric shock to the equipment or the person. Okay, so this is the electromagnetic interference due to the electrostatic discharges. Okay, so the charge accumulation and discharge. A common example involving accumulation of the electrostatic discharge occurs when a person wearing shoes with sole made of an insulating material such as polyurethane foam walk over a carpet made of wool or a synthetic material. So when a person walk through a walk with a shoe which is made up of a polyurethane material and walk through a woolen or any synthetic material, there will be some charges which will be generated in between this polyurethane sole and the wool, and it will transform to the human body. Okay, so here that what about the charge produced here? 10 power minus 6 coulombs or more can be accumulated. It just depends on the nature of the carpet. Okay, so other example: wheelchair, rolling furniture, conveyor belts, cooling fans, plastic roller blades, paper movement in copiers and printers, cleaning with an air gun, packing with PVC layer using hot air blast, cleaning with solvent, thermal blankets, rockets and exhaust nozzles. These are some other examples of this. So this figure just shows the voltage resulting from the electrostatic discharge. Okay, so the accumulated charge seeks the first available opportunity to discharge the unbalanced charge. Okay, so the discharge may occur. This is just the sole, how it is the carpet and the sole, how the voltage variation happens. So the discharge may occur smoothly or as an electric arc in which an intensive discharge takes place over a short period is generated when a release of the charge occurs abruptly. The spark result in a flow of current between the electrodes. So there will be some flow of electrons in between this two. Okay, this time varying current produces both electric as well as the magnetic field. It will just produce the electric and magnetic field. These fields propagate through space and cause electromagnetic interference in the system and components located in the vicinity. Yes, you have to read it. This is the electrostatic equivalence diagram. Okay, human body, arm or finger, and keyboard or machine. This is just the equivalent circuit of the electrostatic discharge. Okay, so it involves a human body, forearm and finger, and an object through which the discharge takes place may be represented as an equivalent electric circuit. When the arm or finger approaches very close to an object, the large electrostatic field intensity may cause dielectric breakdown and result in an arc formation. Okay, so that is the thing here. L1 R1, that is the inductance and resistance of the human body. C1 is the capacitance to ground. Then L2 R2, inductance and resistance of the arm and finger, and appear in series with L1 and R2. C2 is capacitance to the ground, CK capacitance of the object. top to the ground, C3, C4 indicates that the object does not have a direct electric contact with the forearm and the finger. Then the classification of the EMI. Okay. So there it is of four types of the classification of EMI. I'm just saying we can see it in the next class. Radiated emission, conducted emission, radiated susceptibility, conducted susceptibility. These are the four types of electromagnetic classification of the electromagnetic interference. Okay. So that is first one, radiated emission. Okay. It is mainly due to the direct radiation from the source or electrical power signal or control cables of the source to the receptor. Okay. That is the there is a source and victims. Okay. So if there is a direct radiation from the source or electric power signals or control cable to the receptor, we can say it is the radiated emission. So it concerns the electric and magnetic field radiated by a device that may be received by the other electronic device, causing interference in those device. Okay, the first figure shows the radiated emission. Okay, from the source to the receptor, that is the direct radiation. Radiated susceptibility, it's how much the equipment is susceptible to the radiated emission. Okay, then conducted emission. What is conducted emission? It is due to the direct radiation picked up by the power cable, electrical power cables or signals or control cable connected to the receptor via a conduction. So if there is a conduction path in between that, then conducted susceptibility is how much the equipment is susceptible to the conducted emission. These are the thing. So today is just enough for you. So this radiated emission, radiated susceptibility, conducted emission, conducted susceptibility. It is an important topic, and I have some more we have to study in that. Then we can see deeply in the next classes. So today we just look about the various definitions of EMIC. Then sources and victims of EMIC, lightning discharge, two types of discharge, cloud to cloud and cloud to ground discharge, and all we have learned, right? Hope you all understand the topic. If you have any doubts regarding this, you have to ask to me. Okay, if you write the notes, it will be better for your understanding. Okay. Hope you all understand the topic. All okay. Thank you, dear students.